So here we are. All three beds are up and running. Fish are in the tank. You'll notice I got a lot of wee tiny plants in here. Some romaine lettuce, other kinds of lettuces, you name it. Got all kinds of stuff. That's Brussels sprouts in there. Kale through here. A couple of radishes. Lots of spaghetti squash my daughter loves. Sweet corn, just cuz. More spaghetti squash. A sweet corn that may or may not make it. And that's an interesting story. I'll cover that later, but we ended up with an anaerobic environment in our seedling pot and killed quite a few plants over the last few days. So I had to go ahead and bring everything out and put it in the grow bed after I cleaned them really well. Want to get all that those bad bacteria off those plants before we put them in the grow bed. Here's something, I'm not real sure what that is. Then we got just some yellow crookneck squash here and there. You can see, just hold my hand up, how small they are. We went ahead and pulled these, even though they really weren't ready to go in the bed. Same with that sweet corn right there. We went ahead and pulled it just to get it in here and get it away from that anaerobic situation. Got a glass of tea growing over there. It looks to be doing pretty good. But more spaghetti squash. There's cucumbers and cantaloupe, which will run through trellises up through our roof structure as they come up. Same thing with these tomato plants. We'll start moving those up and let them go up through the roof structure. Then over here, we went to a local organic nursery today, close to Canton, Texas. And we picked up a little bit of lavender, some Swiss chard, some chives, and that's about it in this grow bed right now. I've got one sweet corn up here in the corner. Thought I'd put something else here, but I guess not. And that's about it. You may be wondering what this pipe is. When I started doing my auto siphon, I started out with a 3/4 inch pipe. And I didn't want to try to re-drill that hole. So I went ahead and just drilled beside it, put a 1 inch pipe beside it, and use that to make my auto siphon. Let me set this tee down. I'll show you what this auto siphon looks like. Looking down in it. And there it is. And I believe that standpipe coming out of my coupling is about 10 1/4 inches. I don't know the exact measurement here. Two of my grow beds have the same exact measurements. The other one's a little different. And it's just the way things set up. I had to lower that standpipe just a little to make my bell siphon work properly, or my auto siphon work properly. But if you look real close, you can see these tomato plants actually have blooms on them, which they shouldn't have, but they do. I'd probably be wise to pick them off. My one larger plant has been stressed, I assume, from being transplanted so many times, that it's been having some bug issues, some tomato worms that we got here in Texas. I'm sure they're everywhere. I've picked about 8 or 10 off today. And what they'll do is get on a leaf and they'll curl that leaf up around them and make a cocoon. And that's how you find them when they're small. They're very, very difficult to see. I don't see any right now that I could show you. Not sure if that's one or not. No. Not one there, but you can see what they've done to my plant. And I'll be spraying this with my plant mixture here in just a little bit, just to give it a little extra oomph before I take off for the night. I've already put some seaweed extract in the water, probably 1/2 cup for the day, so that'll help also to give us some nutrition while we're waiting on our nitrite to start being changed over to nitrate. And right now we're cycling real well. We're probably halfway through or 3/4 of the way through on cycling. Our nitrite spike is what we're in the middle of right now. Last night we were probably somewhere between 2 and 5 parts per million on our nitrite. So, and our ammonia was way, way down. But nitrate's still showing 0, so that's where we're at. Anyway.